This is a ghost story that has been handed down for generations in the little town of Twaha, located in deep rural Tennessee, with just 300 souls that call it home. The story is about Greg, the milkman and newspaper vendor of the town. Greg delivered milk and the daily newspaper right at the doorstep of every home. He came in an old run-down Ford pickup. Every morning, you could count on a bottle of milk and the newspaper on your front porch. Rain or shine, he did this for a decade or so, never missing a day. One fine day, all of a sudden, delivery stopped. Perplexed and concerned townsfolk inquired at the town's only grocery store that served as Greg's distribution center. The owner of the store, Jim Smith, informed loyal customers that good old Greg had died of self-inflicted gunshot wounds 2 days earlier, near the woods outside town, after making his final delivery run. Jim informed the customers that Greg's family wanted privacy, and the local newspaper did not report about it. But the story spread quickly, by word of mouth. Those were the days before the computer and the internet. News was what the papers reported. The town felt sorry for heartless Greg, as he was such a nice and happy person. Greg had suffered occasionally from melancholia or depression, as it was sometimes called. At the time, depression was considered a mental disease and something you'd not want to talk about for fear of stigmatizing the sufferer even further. However, it did fit as a logical explanation for why heartless Greg had committed suicide. Heartless Greg's grandson, Mike, took the job 2 days later. The town went back to getting its milk and newspaper on time every morning. But then, just a week later, everything stopped again. Was it possible that Mike too suffered from melancholia? Townsfolk wondered, fearing the worst. Thankfully, Mike was found alive and well. But he did have a story to tell. He had decided to quit the job. But why? As Mike described it, he would be at the point of grabbing a newspaper and milk bottle, when both items would then appear on the porch on their own. He knew he had not made the delivery, and yet each time this happened, his load of newspapers and milk was getting smaller too. It was as if he had an invisible helper. Mike was not superstitious, but how could he explain what was happening? If it was an invisible helper, would that not be the ghost of his dead grandfather? Some said Mike had pulled a fast one on the village, to avoid doing the early morning deliveries, and instead opt for a more cushy clerical job in the nearby city. He hoped with his explanation he could maintain his family's good name. And better yet, have a believable and yet also a spooky reason for quitting the job. In those days, the honor of the family name was protected at all costs. It was also a time when most people seriously believed in ghosts. Many people secretly doubted Mike's explanation, but he did have his supporters. Some said they were certain that Mike did not place the bottle and paper on their porches, and vouched that they had only seen him looking amazed and then returning to his run-down pickup. They were not sure what made Mike look amazed. Old folks claim the ghost was originally referred to as Hatless. He was called Hatless Greg because he never wore a hat, which was weird for the times. Over a period of time, due to some mispronunciation among the storytellers, Hatless became Heartless. Heartless Greg's story is part of Tuas Town's folklore. It is a story narrated to young children of the little town every Halloween.